survey says it's 6 o'clock, time for Family Feud. Now, here's your host, Grant Denyer.
Here on Family Feud, where two families guess the answers to some seriously simple questions, and if they get them right, they'll be in the running for $10,000 and maybe even a brand new car. Let's meet our families. First up, our carryover champs from South Australia, the Catalano family.
Did I say it right, Jesse?
You're spot on.
It felt good when I said it.
It was really
just
fun
rolls
to
off
say.
The tongue. Catalano. Beautiful. Who's with you?
Okay, we've got my lovely wife, Laz.
Are you sure?
Yes. And we've got my brother-in-law, Adrian, and my sister, Nadia.
Cool. Good to have you guys here. Ready to take them on tonight from Victoria, the Langmaid family. Great to have you guys here.
Thank
and who
you.
Have you brought with you?
I've brought with me my sister, Cassie, my mum, Sue, and my dad, Rob.
Hi, guys. Lovely to see you. Team captains, round one. Let's play the feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. What's your favourite Mr. Men character? Wow. Jesse.
Grumpy?
Is Grumpy there? Yes, it is. What's your favourite Mr. Men character, Tess?
My favourite is definitely Mr. Tickle.
Mr. Tickle. Ooh, well done. Pass or play? Let's do it. Hey, Cass, how you doing?
I'm good, thanks, Grant.
You've got a Guinness World Record?
Yes,
what
I do.
What for?
The most people doing the Macarena simultaneously.
Oh, really? Oh. How many people was that?
Oh, gosh. 400?
Yeah, was
something
it really?
Like that.
Now, for everybody at home who might not know what the Macarena is,
please
would you
don't
mind? Oh, yeah, I'm going to make you. Are you ready to do it?
Yeah.
Look at you pretending like you can't remember it. Awesome. Aren't Guinness World Records kind of cool?
Oh, yeah.
They become like a bit addictive too. Once you get one, you want another one. That's what happened to me. I got a Guinness World Record for the world's largest tandem bungee jump, which was out of a helicopter, which I went, that was pretty cool. But problem is, no one had ever done it before. So when you jump out and you go down, I went, this is awesome. Then we started going back up and going, what happens next? Has anybody thought about that giant blade up there? But it worked out okay. Go us. What's your favourite Mr. Men character?
My favourite Mr. Men character is Mr. Strong.
Mr. Strong. Yes. Hi, Sue.
Hello.
Lovely to have you.
Thanks.
Favourite Mr. Men character?
I'm thinking of Miss Little Miss Messy.
Hope that's one. Let's see Little Miss Messy. No, first strike. Rob, what's your favourite Mr. Men
character?
Gee,
it's been a while, Grant, since I've been in those books. But I'm going to go with Mr. Happy.
Yes. Let's see.
Yes.
Oh, cool. Makes him for a very happy man.
Yeah.
Good guess, Rob. Tess.
I remember having a T-shirt of this one when I was younger. Little Miss Giggles.
Let's see Giggles on the board. No. What's your favourite Mr. Men character?
I'm going to take a guess and say Little Miss Naughty.
I like it. Is it there? No, it's not. Catalanos can steal in this opening game. Nadia, your thoughts?
Mr. Mischief.
Mr. Mischief.
Mr. Topsy Turvy.
Yeah, lads.
Mr. Bump.
And yes. Jesse. Wonderful options, but yours to choose for the steal.
I'm going to go with my wife, Mr. Bump.
Let's see. No! Congratulations, Langmaid. Get the opening blow. Number 8. Mr. Tall. Mr. Silly. Mr. Messi. Mr. Small. There you go. All wonderful options. So, well done, Langmaid. You get a 62-point advantage in the opening stages of the competition. Congratulations to you. And if you're going for 5 nights in a row, you'll be driving home in a brand-new Mitsubishi Outlander. This great-looking SUV offers CVT auto with paddle shift, hill start control, the unique Mitsubishi multi-communication system. Oh, does it communicate? Yes, it does. And rain-sensing wipers for everybody playing along at home who want the top answer to this one. Name something you associate with Little Red Riding Hood. We'll see you in a moment on The Feud. families are still playing for a chance at $10,000. Now, before the break, I asked, name something you associate with Little Red Riding Hood. The top answer was...
Wolf!
Did you get it? Ace work if you did. Give me Laz, give me Cass, let's play. We surveyed 100 people and the top 7 answers are on the board. Name somewhere you're likely to yawn. Laz.
In your bed.
In your bed. Good. One more answer above it, Cass.
I do it often at uni.
Let's see if your uni is on the board. No, it's not. Pass or play, Laz. Somewhere you're likely to yawn.
Now, as a teacher, I shouldn't be saying this, but I remember as a student, you'd yawn in school.
Yeah. Do your students yawn in front
of you? I haven't caught them, no. No. They're pretty good at hiding it.
That's good. Yeah. And so just a bit of behind the hand sort of deal.
Yeah, they might just turn around and they're out of sight. They're very smart.
Yeah, cool.
Yeah, I'll go to school.
Nice. Somewhere you're likely to yawn?
Seeing someone else yawn.
Oh, the contagious yawn. Yeah. When someone goes first. Ah. I liked your thought, though. Wasn't there. Jesse.
I would say in a cinema.
Do you, if it's a really bad film?
Yes.
Let's have a look. Nice work. You obviously had quite a good labour.
Good labour.
Yeah, quite an easy labour. Because what were you doing right throughout your labour?
I was taking selfies and sending them to my friends.
Yeah. Obviously, here up, I hope.
Yes.
Good, just checking.
Yep.
So you were obviously just you were just loving the experience. And
loved
just
going
straight to Instagram.
Absolutely.
You beauty.
8 minutes of the footy show and she was out.
Yeah, is that right? A nice easy one.
Nice one.
Yay for that.
Yes.
Somewhere you're likely to yawn.
Similar to Jesse's answer, but I'm going to say the theatre.
The theatre? No, second strike. Langmaid's could steal, so have a think, team. Adrian?
Grant, I'm thinking church.
You're in church. Nadia, how about you?
You're home.
Just at home?
Just at home.
That's three strikes, Langmaids. Rob, what do you think?
Ooh, I've got one here, Grant.
Yes.
Not a guess. In the car.
You're yawning in the car?
Yeah, I think so.
Sue?
I was going to say at home, but the others said that, so I'll say in the bathroom.
Yep. Cass?
I'm going to say at work.
Okay, you yawn at work. Tess, yours to choose. One of those options or your own.
Sticking with the sister and I'm going to go at work.
We're going work for some points. Give it to me. Answer 7.
In the car.
Had that too.
Lounge.
Just on the lounge. Nice work, everybody. So it's 0 for our carryover champs, who are $10,000 richer, I might add, after last night. That's because the Langmaids have the control of the competition. Look, we know you love watching Family Feuds, and then why not play along at home with the official Family Feud game? Simply head to 10Play and check out Family Feud for all the highlights, the fun stuff that goes on behind the scenes as well. After the break, it's double points when we come back right here on The Feud. Yet to get on the board. They've got a 0 in front. The Langmaids have it at the moment with 144. But remember, it's double points now for this next question and both families are still in the game. So, give me Adrian, give me Sue. Let's play. We surveyed 100 people and the top 6 answers are on the board. Name something people achieve that they can be proud of. Adrian.
A degree.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah. Nice work. Pass or play. Rob.
Yep.
Okay. So, you're making a surprise for a 40th birthday.
Yeah.
And you're being the great partner.
Exactly.
You know, you're just being thoughtful.
I was.
Coming up with something really special to surprise her with on the birthday.
Yep. Yep.
And whilst you were planning this, what happened? What did she think?
Well, it was a bit of a secret, of course, and Sue here thought I was getting up to some mischief with someone else.
She thought you were having an affair.
Yes, she did.
While you were secretly planning a beautiful birthday surprise for her.
I was...
What triggered her to think this?
Well, I was sneaking out.
For hours. Hours.
So you come up with excuses such as...
to get out of the house.
Yep.
Oh, I had to do some photocopying, or I've got to deliver something to some strange place or some old...
Yeah, some really random locations. You're going, this is a bit sus.
Yeah.
This is a bit sus. And what were you actually doing?
I was going to Sue's friends and family to film them wishing her a happy birthday on a video.
Oh, what a really thoughtful... work, a lot of effort and commitment, and it's a wonderful... And to be accused of something so horrible...
No, she never actually raised it. I never knew she was thinking that. She was good. She just kind of wondered.
And how did you feel when the present was presented?
Yes, it was pretty impressive.
Yeah, it's good. It was well worth it.
It was great.
Nice work. Oh, funny things can happen in relationships, can't they?
Good time.
Yeah. We can laugh about it now, can't we, Rob?
Absolutely.
Yeah, you sure? Yeah. Good on you for putting the effort in. Something people achieve that they can be proud of.
Well, I've done this one. Parenthood, for me.
Lovely answer. Yeah. Is it on the board? Yeah. Nice work, mate. Tess, something people can achieve that can be proud of.
I've got a few of these, so maybe sporting trophies.
Yeah, love that answer. Good. Cass?
I'm thinking along the lines of, like, schoolwork.
Yeah, let's have a look at that. First strike. That's OK. Sue?
I think a promotion.
Yeah.
Yes.
Going really good here. Just two to go, Rob.
Two to go. OK. Well, I've got one grant. Oh, I'm going to say buy a house.
Proud of buying a house. Yep. Second strike. OK, Catalano family could steal, so they're having a think, Tess.
Struggling here. I've got a few ideas, but none of them are great. Maybe travel?
Let's have a look. Is travel on the board? Third strike, Langmaids. Catalano family. Nadia.
OK, proud of your grades.
Adrian.
Yeah, I'll have to go with that one too, Grant.
Laz.
Children.
Jesse, yours to choose.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to go with my sister and brother-in-law on this one. Grades.
Grades? Are grades good? No! Sorry, Catalanos. Miss out on the points. Goes to the Langmaids, which takes in the 300, makes you our brand new champion. Number six. Winning. Sporting abilities. So that snuck up on us. Congratulations, Langmaids. They are our new champs. Nadia! Well, the Catalanos are $10,000 richer from their time here last night on the show. And they'll also be taking home our brand new Family Feud board game, a great Christmas gift available at selected retailers. So thanks for playing, guys. The Catalanos, everybody! Good job. Late notes. Fast money, who's playing? Let's go.
Tessie. Robbies.
Wow, you guys are super players. Congratulations.
Oh, a bit of luck so far, I think, Grant.
Bit of luck. It takes a little bit of skill, too. Next target, $10,000. That's got to be a little nice, a little tantalising.
It is.
Fingers crossed for you. You're back in our soundproof booth first. And you and I are going to play for $10,000 in a little segment that we call Fast Money right here on The Feud. Well done, mate.
Family Feud is on Facebook and Twitter. Plus, you can find us on YouTube and catch all the action on 10Play.
Well, welcome back. It's Fast Money time here in The Feud, so let's see if the Langmaid family can now win some cash, which is a nice bonus when you can bring the family on here. Have a good time primarily.
Yeah.
And then there's always the sweetener at the end of winning some cash.
Yeah, hope so.
Have you thought about this prospect?
A little bit, but, you know, don't get your hopes up.
Whose idea was it to come on the show?
It was Sue's idea.
Lovely.
Yes.
And did she need much convincing, or did you guys need much convincing?
Oh, no, I'm happy to go along with anything. And and Tess seemed keen, and Cassie was happy to come along, so we were all in. There's only four of us, so that's the full family.
Did you do any little practicing before you came in?
Oh, yeah, yeah. We sat down in front of the telly and together and watched a few shows and had a go at it.
Do you reckon it helps?
Oh, it's luck. I think it's luck. I'll get it.
It's skill. Oh, it's a game of skill, Rob. No. You and Tess get 200 points or more between you. You'll win $10,000. Tess is now in our soundproof booth and can't hear the answers. Now I'm going to ask you five questions. Going to give you 20 seconds to answer. If you pass, we'll come back at this time. And the clock starts at the end of the first question. You ready? 20 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck, Rob. Name something that costs more to buy if you're a woman.
Shoes.
Name something you associate with a pillow.
Sleeping.
Name something children fall from.
A bike.
Name something specific you might put in a sandwich.
Meat.
Name the best place on your body to be given a massage.
Your back.
Beautiful. That was skillful. That wasn't luck. Let's go.
No blanks in there.
Well, I gotta say, look, like when you talk about luck, like luck is like 50-50 flip. Yeah. You had to come up with answers, and you did quickly and quite sharply too, so you should be proud of yourself.
Thanks, Grant.
Now, name something that costs more to buy if you're a woman, you said.
Shoes.
Survey says. Nice, good stuff.
Yep, yep.
Something you associate with a pillow, you said. Sleeping, makes a lot of sense. Survey says. Are brilliant. Oh. Name something children fall from. You said a bike. Straight to YouTube. Survey says. Name something specific you might put in a sandwich. You said you are a bloke, aren't you?
Yes.
Yeah, meat. I want a meat sandwich. Just a steak meat sandwich. Survey says six. Name the best place on your body to be given a massage. You said... Long day, yes. Back aches, give me a back massage. Yeah. Survey says...
That is awesome.
Well done, head back the family to the board. Welcome back. Well, if you've been watching the show and you've been doing a little practice at home with the family, you would know that if you only had, say, 68 points to get $10,000, that's a pretty cool position to be in.
Yeah? Bit of pressure, but yeah,
no,
that's pretty good.
Hey, he's done all the work. You just breeze this in from here on in. I'm going to ask you the same five questions, but you're the second player and it's a little harder, so I'll give you an extra 5 seconds, OK? If you pass on a question, I'll ask it again if there's time. And if you repeat an answer that's already there, you'll hear this sound. And I'll ask you to try again. Can we remind everybody of Rob's answers? 25 seconds on the clock too, please. Time starts from the end of the first question. Good luck, Tess.
Thanks.
Name something that costs more to buy if you're a woman.
Clothes.
Name something you associate with a pillow.
Sleep.
Try again.
Bed.
Name something children fall from.
Playground.
Name something specific you might put in a sandwich.
Cheese.
Name the best place on your body to be given a massage.
Shoulders.
Love it! I love it! That was cool! Did you have fun?
Yes.
Let's go. So tell me, was it fun?
Yes, it was.
It was. It looked like you were enjoying it. You finished with a huge smile, like you were very proud of yourself.
It was over.
It's a bit like that, is it?
So you win $10,000. Now what would you do?
I think Mum's really keen to get to New York for Christmas, so maybe that might be on the cards.
A white Christmas? In New York? That would be epic.
It would be epic.
That's cool. That's a good dream to have.
Yeah.
Let's see if we can work towards the dream. Name something that costs more to buy if you're a woman. You said clothes. Pretty confident in that as an answer?
Fairly confident.
Let's see. Survey says 22. We can buy some winter woolies to get you guys there. The top answer was haircut. So we now need 46 for $10,000 and to go to New York. Name something you associate with a pillow. You said? Why bed? Because they go...
On the bed.
On the bed. Survey says... 14. Sleeping was the top answer and Rob had that, so well done, Rob. 32 to go. Name something children fall from. You said playground. Survey says 21. Had you said tree, you would have had the top answer. We now only need
11 for $10,000.
So what's when you picture being in New York at Christmas time, in winter, next Christmas, what's it like? What are you picturing?
Picturing snow and probably ice skating.
Yes.
Up there too.
In Central Park.
Yeah.
When they turn the lake into, yeah, with the backdrop of the skyline and
yeah.
You're just doing your thing.
Something like that.
Is that your skiing face? And you can do it at Rockefeller Centre as well. So there's two locations you can do it, right in the heart. That's pretty awesome.
Yes.
Oh, man, what a place. You said, name something specific you might put in a sandwich. Cheese. We need 11 or more for $10,000. They love cheese in the States. It's on everything. It's a weird colour, though. It's like orange. It's like random. It's not yellow. It's like weird.
And it comes in the can?
Yes! Doesn't it? And they love it on their pizza. Famous New York pizza slices. Yep. You'll be eating plenty of them because survey says... Yeah! Well done, guys. $10,000 and they are going to have a white Christmas in New York next Christmas time. The top answer was ham. The final top answer was back, which is what Rob had. Well played, guys. The project's coming up next. Remember, Big Bash right here on 10 tonight. We'll see you all tomorrow. I'm Grant Daniel. It's going to be a wonderfully white Christmas for these guys. Good night, Australia.